This is the X5 I50. Well, the I50. So this one is the V8. Yeah, 50i. X will consider 50i. Sorry, y'all. When you're in the car business, you have to remember all this car stuff. So yes, actually, always gonna show y'all the trunk. So this is the trunk. This one doesn't have the third row. You can do the option the third row right here. But why you would want a third row when you have the X7? And then it stays up there. That's pretty cool though. And you have all your stuff over here. This is for instigation and stuff like that to keep the ride more quieter. And then you got over here when you want to hide your stuff. And then over here you can push this down too. And you can actually sit on it too. If you want to sit on it like you, and stuff like that. And you can put it up. And then usually, like, let's say you have this down, right? And you press this. They go up fast, right? This one is the V6, this one is the V8. But it's, I just viewed a nice one for you. I like the brakes. This one has the more fatter wheels, and this one does. This one is at the V8 one, so this one is pretty quick. My cousin has one of these, and these are very nice. He has like the 2018 one. So this is the egg room in the back because the seat is all the way back. You get sunshade over here. Oops. To put up. I'm surprised it's not power. It's so hard to put up with one hand though. That's how it goes up. And then you got your tin right here, your Panoramic sunroof. You can get this is right here to put your, if you want, to get the entertainment system at the two TVs. My cousin has a third row in the back. He has another row in the back. So yeah. This is a cup holders. I never see one with a third row. This one don't come with it. This one has heated seats. This one has, yeah, if you can turn it down and turn up the east temperature on both sides of how you like it. You know what I mean? So you know what I mean. So it's pretty comfortable. You got your ambient lighting right here, your station, your speaker grill under here. It's soft touch right here. Then you got your cup holder. So this is how the car is actually running right now. So I can't show you how the smart key access, so I just have to show you how it works. So what do you do, how you do it, you just press right here and you yak it. So usually in some BMWs you can hold it down. This one come with the feature, you hold it down. And it optional, like you say, closing the mirrors when you hold it down. Usually some of these X5s, you hold it down and some of them will start automatically. This one have it. And then if you want to turn it off, if you want to open it, and then if you want to turn it off, I try to figure out how to turn it off. The other BMW is different, but this one has this, the start stop. Yeah, like when you refresh it, it's so hot on here. So when you're coming up to the car, so I'm gonna turn it off, right? So you press it and you yak it. Then you hold on this to close in the mirrors. So what you do, you kind of hold on this button. And you just hold it down. Now you press it 2 times, and then you're gonna hold it down, and then you keep on holding it, and usually it will start. It start the other time. It's like either way how you can do it. Sometimes it works. So you have to hold, you press it 2 times, and then it start. And then how you take it off. Okay, you press it 2 times to turn it off. So, and then how you get in. That's how you get in. The interior is gorgeous though. You got your power mirrors and stuff like that. You got your nice comfortable seats though. So let me see, this is how, this one has the optional door close. And then you put your foot on the brake. Even same if it's in start-stop mode, you still put your foot on the brake. This one has the dual zone. So like, it has dual zone on either side. You can, you say that the passenger wants his fan speed to be more over. And the passenger want his speed to be more higher, so like it's different. I like that because some people doesn't want it blown in their face, so you can turn it down, and then you can show the temperature. This one doesn't come with the optional ventilated seats, and you can get that part of a package. You can get the optional ventilated seats, so this one don't come with it. That's a bummer. This one happened to come with, this one come with navigation. This one come with a head-up display too. This one is sticker at 90,000. The only thing that's just missing is the ventilated seats though. The ventilated seats, so that's kind of bummer that the X5. So this is just missing ventilated seats. This one has a lot of features. You get your 60 view camera. You get your parking assist. Like you say, you coming up to a vehicle, it will back you in. Like stuff like that. So I wonder, should I try this system? It shows you how far you are from the car. You say you put it into reverse. You have to hold on this button, and then when it comes out, let's say you're coming out, and you just put down the parking brake. It shows you how much feet and stuff you are from the vehicle, like that. Then it has like rear parking sensors too, and then it has park pilot too. Like if you're coming up and it sees like, okay, you can fit in that spot, it beep at you, you can fit in that spot. So this one has parking sensors too, so the mirrors will go down, so it shows you how close you are related to the car, and that's pretty nice too. And show you how it goes. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna put it back because it shows you the front. So I like that though. It shows you, like you say, you're coming out of these two cars, you're coming out, and so you can't see nothing from the other side of the car, you know what I mean? So oops. So you can't see nothing from the other side of the car. So that shows you. Like you see this car going, and you see all the way down there, and that's pretty neat, and I like that, because you be parked next to two big cars you can't see, and that goes the same for the rear of the car too. That goes like for the rear of the car, and it's nice. I like it. It has then you can turn, and it has like sensors around the car, and you can see at the side of the car, the other side of the car, how far you are in, with the car, and when it moves back. So stuff like that you can see. Then it has park pilot and all that stuff like that. So what we gonna do, we gonna put it back into park. So, and then that miracle is up too. This one is a touchscreen, I like it. You got your stuff right here to show your stuff. This one comes with the optional sound system. You guys asking, this one comes with the optional sound system. It's kind of like I got a little bit of yearning curve, but when you get used to it, you see how it sounds. So you can twist, you can turn, you can do all that stuff, shoot, and it this like it has either sensor around here. It can see where your hand is going, if you wanna go up, if you wanna go down, or you wanna when you're making phone calls, it can go like that. So there's a lot of nice features in here too. I like that they that came out on the BMW, I think the 7, then it just trickled to all the other BMWs. These are the goodies. So you want all them on, you get your blind spot, you get your Yankee assist, your automatic high beams, your adaptive cruise control, you get all that in this car. You get your pre-collision system, pedestrian system, it will automatic brake if a kid run out in the car. You get all that with it. So it's nice though. You get all those features with it. So down here you got your parking sensors. If you want to turn those on or you want to turn it off, to me I would just keep them on. So when it start beeping, and then you have parking sensors at the front of the car. You say if you're backing up, and you see another car, if you're going into the driveway, if you're going into your garage, this will beep at you, telling you you're too close to the wall. You know what I mean? Back up. You're like, yes, disco. So, yes, show you guys how does it work. Let's say you're going close, so you just like creeping out, and it will show you where you're around the car. And then when you're creeping, it will have you like your parking sensors right here. See how it shows you right there? You're going too close to the thing, and it will start beeping at you. So when it tells you you're going to red, so it tells you right there on how the car is. So you know what I mean? And then if you want to back it up, you put it into reverse. So it's actually steering the car. It's actually straightening up the wheel. And that's pretty nice though. It's actually turning the wheel and it's sensing where your tin is at. So how this is a pretty cool feature, and I like this to death though. And how you put it back into park, you just press that. And then over here, you got your adaptive cruise control. All this adaptive cruise can shrink the ink, how much ink you want it. Okay, so you can go for real far. And then over here, you got your lights. Over here, you got your memory seats. Your tinted fold in your mirrors. And over here, you got your space thing right here. Over here, you got your sunroof like that, then you got your homing system, and then you got your navigation, and it's nice though. You can pinch, it's a nice navigation though. I like the navigation. Then you go right here for your car settings. This one has the optional, this one has the all-wheel drive. You have the off-road drive too. You want to off-road, and then you have your power. You have your power mode. So you can see how much power, how much, I don't know, it has a lot of features in here. You can take it off, roll, you can put it on, roll. So it's a lot of nice stuff. So, you know what I mean? It then has little sensors to watch you here too. You can customize the car how you want it to act. Like wheels and all that, wheels is fine. It shows you one of the wheels. It's kind of yo, this one right here. Okay. So it's showing you one of the wheels, though. So it shows you all the information. You can see what's going on with the car. Then you can go back right here. You can go to your settings like that, how you want the settings. So you can all control right here. You can write. Then there's other buttons right here to go to your nav. If you want to go to, and it's easy to type in something too. So it's really easy though. And I like that. And then over here, you got your radio control, got your menu. So it's a lot of nice stuff. And then over here, you got your optional. This is optional with the car. I don't know what the heck this is. I think this is what you put your smoke stuff into. And then over here, you got your, you know, tin deck. If you put your cup in and it's cold, or if you want it heated, it will heat like your tea and stuff in there. So that's pretty nice though, and I like this. Yeah, you got your charge port. I know you have my charge port next to the cup holders, and I have a reason. And you got your wire charger under here. So it's pretty nice. This is optional. So, and then if you don't want to see, you can always just close it. So that'll make it much better. And then this is how you show your radio right here. Your climate control. You got your paddle shifters. You got your auto wipers. And then right here shows navigation. And over here shows where your face is. So where your face is turning, it will automatic brake for you. Stuff like that. Event you not to crash the vehicle. You know what I mean? So that's I like that feature. So I attempted to show you guys how does the car park itself, and I think that's a really cool feature. Let's go in and show you how does the car park itself. You got your hill control, and that you got your start stop, and then your hill control down. You have a nice set of goodies right here that you sport mode. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna call the turn. So what we can do, we kind of like going in like you parking, right? So you're going in like you parking. So what we can do, we can actually put it into reverse. So, and then you press park, and then you press where you want to go. So you get your foot off the brake, and I'm so nervous. So you just press the gas. So what is it doing is steering for you. So it sees the parking. You just have to press the gas. And it's just going to be parking for you. And it sees the cars and stuff in front of it. So it sees it right there. So what it's going to do is going to go down. So what we can do, we is kind of put it back into reverse, and it's kind of back up. It's not working, like. So it's kind of like staring. So it's kind of like being trouble sometimes. See, it's kind of like parking itself though. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna straighten it back up again. So what we're gonna do is press this and you put it into reverse. So it's actually gonna straighten up. So when it's green, that's mean like it's ready. So now it's just like straightening it back up again, say I'm too close to that car. Okay, so it kind of failed for me in the minute, but see how it's like beeping at you? But it was working like a minute ago. You kind of see how did it work. Okay, so I'm gonna go back up a little bit more. So I like that feature. That's a really nice feature. Hold up. Okay. So then you gauge the parking brake and you see how you look like that. That's a really nice feature, and I like that feature because a lot of people doesn't know how to park this big of a vehicle. And you know what I mean, when you're parking it, you can just press these two stuff on and it shows you if you want to back it in, this one if you want to park the vehicle. So this one is just backing in. So you back in the vehicle in into this parking. You see how when it shows it's red and it's looking at you, so it can see if you focus and stuff like that. So I like this is a very nice option. And then right here, you got your 60-year view, like around the car. Then you can go like how you want it to go, like this. I don't know. It's like it's a nice feature. And then you can see the side of the car and stuff like that. So I like that feature, and I like the navigation too. The navigation is real crisp. You can see stuff around the car, and I like that. And then it's. And then this is a electric, so don't be part of pulling it out. It's a electric. So what we can't do, kind of come up the vehicle because I'm having too much fun. This is power, so don't be try to be pushing this out. This one is power. You just press it, and then this is power too. See, you can go over this part, or you can higher up this part right here. And then, if you want to do the whole thing, so that's pretty nice. And then this is power too. I don't see any heated steering wheel, so this one don't have a heated steering wheel. So what we're gonna do? We're gonna shut it off. So when you exit out, it kind of like the steering wheel will be move. Oh, the heated steering wheel is right here. I so used to being it right here in some other BMWs. But it's right here, y'all. And you got your Bluetooth and stuff like that. So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna come up the vehicle. And this one has the cell closing doors too. So, we're gonna lock it. So, this is the vehicle. And it's very nice. I like this vehicle. It's very comfortable. It's very sporty. It's very nice. It's sporty. It's very nice. It's very comfortable, and it's very. It's like if you want a family. If the X5 is too big for you, the X7 is too big for you. Consider this. This is more cheaper. If you don't want something that big, you know what I mean. So, This X5 is nice. This one has the optional head lamps on it, the optional automatic shutters, the parking sensors. It looks different from the rest of them. You see how that one looks to how this one looks. Look at this one. And look at this one. This one has the Xenon side, how you say it. The LEDs from the Xenon. So these are adapted. They corner, they illuminate the road much better, those head lamps do. And they work way much better, and they, I find them more better in the nighttime, and you got your duck right there to cool down the brakes and stuff like that. So subscribe and yeah for more videos, and please post what do you want me to do next, and because I like to read y'all posts. So subscribe and yeah for more videos. Bye y'all.